Now, I would like to invite our coordinator, Dr. Subodh Panda sir, to welcome the gathering. Sir, please.
Thank you, Sravan. Good afternoon and a warm greetings to every one of you present over here. It is an honor and privilege for me to welcome you on behalf of Institution Innovation Council, Pragati Engineering College. From the bottom of my heart, I welcome the today's resource person, Mihir Shah. Sir, we are eagerly waiting for your delivery and hope your delivery will give us a new shape and dimension to look towards a better vision and mission. Sure, you are highly welcome, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for your warm greetings. Thank you so much, sir.
I am very much delighted to welcome all our dignitaries, professors, HODs, key functionaries of Pragati Engineering College, my IIC team and faculty participants. Respected sir and madam, you all are highly welcome. Dear student participants, I feel happy to welcome you all. You are not only beautify the program, you are made to make the program more purposeful. Even though Principal sir is physically not present in this program due to busy schedule, sir, we acknowledge all your support. We are really the pillar of IIC and backbone of all this program for making it success and get purposeful. Before we begin this webinar, I would like to express my gratitude to every one of you for your sincere commitment towards the program for making it fruitful. So once again, I welcome you all and thank you. Over to Sravan.
Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to introduce our resource person, Mihir Shah, sir. Sir is a reputed sales trainer, speaker, and motivator who transforms business and terms with insightful training. With a decade of experience in corporate sales training, he is sought after his latest technique to drive faster skills, higher efficiency, and sustained development. Mihir's sessions have inspired more than 450 corporate companies all over the country. He is responsible for industry-leading corporate training, leadership training, sales training, and sales consultancy that have a strong, lasting impact. With a keen understanding of employee psychology and drive to aspire success, Mihir Shah, sir, CEO, Yatrat Marketing. Sir, the stage is open for you, sir. Please.
Thank you so much, Ravan, for giving a quick introduction, and thank you so much. So, regarding further communication, first thing which I would like to request, Ravan, to your entire students, that they should switch on their cameras. They should switch on their cameras. If they have webcam, kindly switch on the webcam. Because see, when we do, most of you wants to start your own business. And that is something which we are going to discuss for next 55 minutes. And my introduction, I will do on a later stage. First, let's see a small video. See, basically as an entrepreneur, our main goal is to create a large brand, a business, innovative business, which everyone needs, which fulfill everyone's needs, and definitely they can solve the issues of society. So for that purpose, first, let's see a small video. What is brand and how it is developed? And then after, we will do certain discussions about the generic life, how we can be innovative, where we need to improve ourselves, how to settle down goals, and how to achieve them. Today, as we have just 55 minutes, so I will try to cover up as much as I can, and then remaining discussions, we will keep doing it. And meanwhile, during the sessions, if you have any question queries, you can raise your hand, and Shravan, you can unmute the people who wants to ask the questions, okay? So let's start with a small video about how a large brand has been evolved.
Thank you. Voice is not audible.
Sir, audio is not coming, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir,
audio. Sir, no audio.
Sir, you are muted, sir. Sir, excuse me, sir. You are muted.
I was on unmute. So I was like just playing the video. Would you like to see the video again? Shravana, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir. Now
yes,
you
sir. You are audible now, sir. Sir, but the video has been cut off.
Sorry? Could you repeat? Your voice is breaking a bit.
Sir, in between that audio was not came, sir.
Okay, let's repeat it. It's just of 2 minutes. But let me ask you first question. Shravan, you need to coordinate with me because I don't know your teammates. So first thing, how many of you guys wants to develop a large brand, a huge brand? Just raise your hands. How many of you wants to build a large brand? Okay, so man, Uma, Lokesh. Okay, thank you so much, Lokesh. Who else wants to build a large brand? Only 6 people wants to build a large brand. So what is your concept about brand? What is brand according to you?
Sorry, sir. Gram.
According to you, a brand, a big name, a large organization. What is that?
Brand, which gets simpler, brand value or brand? Yes, sir.
A brand. What is a brand?
You can ask the participants to post their answers in chat and read.
Sure.
Okay, sir. I request the participants to post your answers in the chat box.
How many of you wants to build a large brand? Hello.
Sir, 8 members have raised their hands, sir.
Yes, only 8 members. And what you want to do, Shravan? Would you like to build a brand or not?
Yes, sir. I am also interested in building a brand, sir.
Okay, so what is your idea? What is your idea?
Firstly, I should learn. Yes, sir. Firstly, I should learn the process, the proper path and process, sir.
Mm-hmm.
So how to start in a startup.
How to start a startup. True.
Yes, sir.
So let's repeat the video. Now I am audible, right, Shravan?
Yes, sir, you're audible, sir.
And now you can hear the voice of audio. right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So just spend 30 seconds with this video and you will be able to know how to build a brand the way we build it.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Sir, video has been unshared, sir. You're muted, sir.
Sir, you have been muted, sir.
Muting me because I am not able to mute myself. I have just played the video.
So we cannot see the video actually.
So we cannot see the video, sir.
Okay. Sir, could you just do me a favor? That only take their access from with you and me only. The access with you and me only. There should not be other person who should be able to access the systems. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Mute all option, I think so, because I got a notification that someone had.
Rajesh, sir?
Yes.
Sir.
Oh, sir, you can proceed now, sir.
Sir, again you are muted, sir. Sir Rajesh, sir, please check it, sir.
Rajesh, sir, kindly take the.
Sir, I'm looking into it.
Sir, somebody muting, sir. Please, sir, check it, sir.
Rajesh, kindly check it out. Someone is muting me. Sean, how are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, you're audible.
I think the problem is the video only, sir.
Rajeshji, again, I am muted.
Sir, I think the problem is the video only, sir.
Okay, now are you able to hear me, Sean?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's stop this video. there is no need. See, first thing which I would like to tell to all the students, whatever things which we are trying to do, it is for betterment of yourself. And this is the reason why we generally, whenever we are having sessions, we are using Zoom calls instead of using Microsoft Meeting, where these challenges are there. Everyone can do what they like to do. For next 50 minutes, if you want to hear me, that will be a really appreciable job, because something which I am going to tell you is about the entire life. Hello? Yes, sir. So whatever things which we are going to discuss for next 55 minutes, it is all about creating a big brand, how you can start your innovative startup, how you can present it into the market. With decade of experience, I have learned the ways how we can position ourselves. Now, first thing, from childhood, we have learned one thing: competition is good. How many of you think that competition is good? Raise your hand. Because this is one core mentality which we have learned from beginning of our school day. Everyone have learned this thing that competition is good. When you compare yourself with others, it will help you to boost up your own capabilities. It motivates you. It creates benchmarks. So many things we have learned from childhood that competition is good and we need to compete with others. Now, when we talk about this particular thing, we need to understand few organizations who have created their large brand value, like Amazon. Who is the nearest competitor of Amazon? If anyone can tell me a nearest competitor of Amazon in chat box. If anyone can tell that the nearest competitor, closest competitor, who is the closest competitor of Amazon? Quickly. In chat bot only, no direct conversations. Who is the toughest competitor of Amazon? Nearest competitor. Or let's take Google. Who is the closest competitor of Google? So according to you, who is the closest competitor of Google?
I don't have any idea, sir.
Okay, just a second. Could you read out the text options? What people are saying, who is the closest competitor of Amazon?
Yes, sir. Amazon, they're saying Flipkart, SpaceX,
Flipkart,
Netflix,
Flipkart, Alibaba. So we got few options of Alibaba, Flipkart. Okay, so now understand one thing. Amazon is not just into e-commerce. They are into book publishing. They are into IT infrastructure. They are into innovative products. Now Flipkart, it's like a baby. Flipkart is a baby. It's just a small baby. You are comparing ant with the elephant. Amazon is the largest organization in terms of e-commerce. Flipkart doesn't have maximum 10% share. Google, there is no competition. In terms of Amazon, if you are telling Alibaba, Alibaba is just popular in China. See, understand one thing. There are products who are popular in China because of the population of China, they are making revenues. But in terms of overall analysis, you won't find Alibaba. People in USA won't order from Alibaba. Their first preference will be Amazon only. Flipkart is just popular in India. Amazon is the leader. Google, without the help of Google, we won't be able to do anything. In a single day, we won't be able to do anything if Google goes down. There is only one for Google. You can name the Walmart. Walmart is again not at all a competitor. Yahoo is almost absolutely. So in terms of Google, they have 98% search share in the market. Bing is just popular in China. Facebook. Now let's talk about the Facebook application. Everyone use Facebook? Every one of us use Facebook. In the morning, the first thing which we do is we open the Facebook. Now, when we talk about the competition of Facebook, don't give answers like Instagram. If you are using Instagram, just close the Instagram, restart the Instagram, you will see powered by Facebook. If you are using WhatsApp, close and check powered by Facebook. There are 32 social media applications who might be competitor for Facebook. They have taken over them. Lockheed Martin, world's largest private plane provider. Walt Disney. If you look all these organizations, Netflix, people will say Amazon Prime. Amazon Prime is just popular in India. Netflix is a entirely a different era. The budget which Netflix is spending on the marketing, that is the total revenue of Amazon Prime in a year. So this all organization, they have made their name as a brand, because if you think Facebook, what Facebook does, they are changing your pattern of living. Google, just understand, in past we were supposed to remember so many addresses, so many things. Now because of Google, we don't need to do that. We just put up doctors nearby me and we find all the data. We need to remember, in past we were required to remember the maps, roads, to reach one destination to other destination. Now what we are doing, we are just opening the map. It had reduced our requirement of storing things in our memory. Tesla, just on the basis of innovative idea, they were able to create millions of money. All these organizations had dominated that industry. And as a startup, as an innovative startup, your focus must be to solve some issues of the society, and second, dominate the market. When you compete, like today in education's era, you guys are competing with each other in terms of marks, in terms of hobbies, in terms of lifestyle, everything. We are trying to copy from someone else, but don't do that. Because when you are copying someone, competition is not at all good. Competition will make you dumb because you will start comparing yourself with others. As an organization, as an individual, you need to understand one thing, that everyone has some different capabilities. Each and every individual is having some different capabilities. And according to the capabilities, we need to capitalize on that strength and we need to remove the weaknesses. But the moment we start comparing ourselves with others, we are trying to live their life. Same way, most of the innovative companies who started their business, they are not able to create a success because of the only one reason. The moment they start the company, they start comparing themselves with others. And the moment they start comparing themselves with others, they are just becoming a followers who are just following some other organization, their marketing idea, their product idea, their thinking pattern. And the moment you are trying to follow someone, he is going to grow, you will grow. But all the time you will feel that you are a loser because that other company is going to get more success than you because you are just following. And that is the reason why, if you want to create an innovative organization, if you want to create a brand name in the market, the first thing which you need to focus is on domination part, where you are not comparing yourself with others, you are just making yourself better than yesterday. Every day you are trying to do innovation, every day you are trying to do innovative thing, every day you are trying to improve yourself. Then only you will be able to create an organization which is a brand and people are using it every day. To give you my quick introduction, I am a founder and co-founder of Yathat Marketing Solution. Me and my partner Mithul Patel, we have started this organization in 2012. And our core focus is to help people, organizations to reach new heights in terms of sales revenues, digital marketing revenues, and in terms of finding new opportunities in the market. Since 2012, we have started multiple other companies like Bit2Man. We have acquired one of the UK-based company, MyPrint Cloud. Then we started Yathat Management Solution. We have started almost 6 organizations in a span of 8 to 10 years. And since last 4 years, I'm getting base sales trainer and personal life coach award from Middle East Asia. And a part of that, there are other credentials, 1,000+ credentials are there. And in 2020, we have started the Mihir Shah Private Limited. So this is I have started all these organizations from scratch with my own fundings, and I had made them profitable within 6 months, maximum 6 months, my break even will be there. And then we are making profit. So now the biggest challenge with us is most of the people in India has nothing to aim. And they hit it with accuracy. Out of you, most of the people doesn't know their goals. They are just into this college because one of their close friend had taken admission in this course. So they need to take the admissions. One of the relative have suggested this particular course, so they need to take the admissions. So the biggest challenge with us is we have never kept our goals and we have never took them seriously. So to name, Mr. Uma Shankar Kumar, if you can unmute yourself, what is your goal? Mr. A. Uma Shankar Kumar.
Sir, thank you for asking me. I wanted to start up a professional chapter for environment, sir. I'm not the student of this institution. I got a link from my email. I'm already working with the colleges and universities to start a professional chapter in the field of environment. Now, currently I started with green and environmental audits of the institution. So we succeedingly did it for 5 institutions. I'm an alumni of JNTU. So now I'm trying to target the JNTU. From JNTU, we have almost 159 affiliated colleges. Since I'm an alumni, with the support of my network and contact with the government, because I was a presidential awardee also. I was with the state and central government work sectors. So I thought I'll build a network with the help of the government. And initially, I have my own brand of my name. So with this branding and the support of the government, I thought I'll start the youth environmental chapters across the India. Tomorrow, in the next down the line 5 years, I should be a brand where, you know, environment, if they say top, we should be the only market in terms of activities, in terms of outcomes, in terms of anything you say environment, we should be the first approach to the government.
Want to become a synonym of environmental issues or any things which they need to do with environment projects.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
That's really great. So have you kept it in front of you? Have you kept this goal in front of you? Have you written down somewhere?
Yes, sir. I have written down the vision. Mission. I already registered it as an Section 8 company. Last 1 week back, I got it from the MCA.
Okay, that's
now great. It's the way how to start, because it's the pandemic. I was working on with the people how to come out and bring out a good team. Really, basically I failed in was building the appropriate team.
Okay.
Because it's not a one man task.
Uma, next slide is about your team only. Don't worry about it.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Yes, Shravan, what is your goal? Shravan.
I do want to launch a brand, sir. As a fertilizer and pesticides company.
Okay.
As I am a diploma student, sir. I did my apprenticeships in Coromandel International Limited, sir.
Okay, that's really good.
I saw the revenue, income, and the advantages and the brand value of Coromandel, sir.
Okay, that's really
so
great.
So I do want to lead a competitive company to Coromandel, sir. As it's a top in India, it's a top one, sir. I do want to become number one. Yes, sir.
Sir, you're muted.
Okay, someone has muted. Okay. So understand one thing. When you are trying to compete with Coromandel, you will be doing things which they have already done. So will there be any difference between you and them? Why people are going to take your product?
Yes, sir. The quality and the quantity does matter, sir.
See, one thing we need to understand, that is the biggest difference. See, we all human are living in 4 degrees of human mankind. One is do nothing. See, you will find most of the people around you in this particular degree where they are doing nothing. They are not changing any things in life. They are just living like morning, evening. They are just leaving the premises. They are not having any innovative ideas. They just want to see the things around them, and according what ever things are happening, they will just follow that things. They are always negative. They don't have any mission, vision in life. They don't have any.
Again,
sir,
you're muted.
Sorry to interrupt you, sir. Again, you're somebody.
Rajesh, sir, I would request that somebody is meeting. So kindly take that control. Can you take that control? Okay. So coming back to the point. So one thing we need to understand, that there are people who are doing nothing in the life. These people are not creating any impact. See, every one of us are getting one life, and we need to create an impact of that life into the world. And we, all of us, needs to create a legacy. Till the time you are not creating a legacy, the purpose of your living will not be fulfilled. And to create that legacy, you need to come out of from do nothing. And you need to do something better. Now, this do nothing people are always negative. They doesn't have any mission in their life. Then the second level, retreat. Now you need to identify in which particular degree you are living, because you are the better judge of your own life. See, in retreat, always there will be people around you. In colleges, these are the people who could be like your seniors, super seniors. Whenever you are trying to do any new innovative things, they will tell you, no, don't do this. In past, we have done this and it failed miserably. There are some people who has this mentality. Before starting anything, they will feel negative. Most of us also, like with us also, it might be happening that when we are trying to do anything, there are some negative thoughts that don't do it. It will be not successful. It won't be that much effective. People will laugh on you. See, understand one thing. The biggest difference is the biggest mindset which you need to change to become a successful and become a failure. We always discuss that to be a successful is hard job than to be a failure. Failure, but according to my decade of experience, being failure is the most difficult part because of one thing. To be a failure, first you need to find out certain activities which can take your time, important time, and which can force you to do non-productive things. So first thing, you need to identify those activities. The second thing, you need to find out reason why things are not working, why the world is not good, why your ideas are not working, why your organization is not making money, why other friends are not supporting you, you have financial crisis, you have this, that. You need to find 10, 20, 100 reasons, which will also consume your time. Whereas to be a successful, it's quite simple job. You need to make one target, you need to follow it. Whatever things, whatever failures are coming during that particular thing, I won't say as a failure, but whatever learnings are coming, you just need to learn the things, what are good things, what are bad things, and you just need to overcome those challenges. So to be a successful is quite easy job. You just need to keep one particular goal. And once you have kept that goal, you just need to focus on that goal till the time you are not able to achieve it. So being a successful is quite easy. Retreat people has always negative thoughts. And if you have some people like this around you, try to avoid them. Because the more you will be in the company of retreat people, they will make you do nothing. The third level is normal level, which is with most of the startup, with most of the people, they always try to compete with others. 9-to-6 job, average product, average lifestyle, average. Everything is average. Now understand, every one of us are watching cricket. In cricket, there are 3 segments in any Indian team or any team in the world. There are 3 segments. One is batsman, the second all-rounder, the third is Shivalaya, sir, are you able to, would you like to share something? The third level is always a bowlers who wants to be there. So now when we, Shravan, ask your organizer, yes, to give me rights of sharing the screen. My screen is
okay, not sir. Rajesh sir, I request Rajesh sir to give the permission of Mahesh sir to share the screen.
Okay. I'm looking into it.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So normal people lives a normal life. Same way in Indian team. If you see the batsmen, they will be fixed. The bowlers, they will be fixed. But the all-rounders are keep changing on the basis of their performance. Same happens to us also. If we are just providing average product, average things, then people won't respect you. So to live the life or to make a large brand, you need to come out of with that comfort zone. You need to deliver something which is unique, which is 100% new. And at the same time, if you are going with the same similar product, then also there should be some major differentiators. And to achieve all these things, you need to go with a massive level of actions. Rajesh sir, could you give me access to share the screen?
Sir, someone has made an attendance. I have made you as a presenter, but someone removed you from presenter.
This was the reason I had asked you that let's use Zoom. Okay, so how to share the screen now?
Okay,
I got the rights. I got the rights, Rajesh. So, are you able to see my screen? Could you just confirm?
No, sir.
Now?
No, sir.
Is it visible now?
Yes, sir. Now it's visible, sir.
Okay, so there are few people who doesn't want success and they also don't want others to be successful. So it happens with all the this educational webinars. So now to live a better life, the only thing which you need is massive. Till the time you are not living a massive life where you don't have shortage of money, where you don't have shortage of things, you are doing whatever you want to do. To live that life, you need to come out of, first thing which you need to do is you need to come out of your comfort zone. And the second thing, you need to settle down some massive goals. See, up to now, we have received only one thing. That goal should be SMART. We will talk on that SMART goals also. So how many of you want to live this type of massive life? Just make an idea and also do analysis where you are right now. Are you in do nothing, retreat, normal level or massive level? Now, from childhood and in your college also, you will learn one particular thing, which is SMART goals, right? Umaji, you have heard about SMART goals? Goals should be SMART, right?
Strong? Yes, sir.
Okay, what do you think, Uma? Goals should be SMART. So every one of us are using smartphones. Anyone is over here who is using dumb phone? Now understand one difference. When we are using smartphones, we just need to tell it that wake me up at 6 a.m. and automatically it rings at 6 a.m. and you are woke up. Now if goals are smart, so what will happen? We just need to tell goals that I want to start an organization like Umaji. He just need to tell the goal that I want to become a synonym to environmental issues in India. If anyone needs solution, they need to come to me. And then he needs to take a rest. Goal automatically goes into the market and it creates the brand, but it is not possible. See, from our childhood, we have learned one thing, SMART goals, which is specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-based. Specific, definitely goals should be specific. What you want to achieve, it should be specific. Measurable, definitely you should be able to quantify it. But when we say attainable, that is where something different is happening. Now, today, a few days back, there was one discussion going on in India that 98% of Indian economy is held by 1% of the people, industrialists. Remaining 99% of the population is just living with that remaining 2%. Now people had started to talk that it is an economical imbalance. If you ask me, it is not because of that industrialist. It is just because of us. Because they have never thought about attainable goals. When we say attainable goals, it means you should be able to attain it. So you will be going to limit your thinking. You will be going to limit yourself by saying, isse zyada nahi ho payega. You won't be able to do larger than this. You won't be able to do anything about this particular stage. Now, when we settle down certain goals, from decade of my experience with this entire corporate world, no company is able to achieve 100% of their target. It may be most of the time, 99% time they will underachieve. Only 1% of the time organizations might overachieve the targets which they have kept. Because one thing we need to understand, when we settle down certain targets, numbers, a small number, we are going to give because we need to keep attainable goals. So we are going to keep things which we may be able to attain. Now to attain that things, according to the numbers or according to the target which we have kept, we will start putting our efforts. If target is small, we are going to put small efforts. If target is large, definitely we are going to put more efforts and we may achieve more. In simple ways, if I as a salesperson do keep one target that I want to make 1 lakh additional income in this particular month. So what I will do, according to 1 lakh, I am gonna decide that I need to make 2 more sales training. So for that, I need to reach 10 people. And out of that 10, I need to convert 2. So I will try to reach out 10 people. Now, if I have kept, and might be possible that I achieve 50% or 90% of the target, then the amount will be 90,000 as an additional income. Now in second scenario, if this was my attainable goal, now if I go with an other number, where instead of 1 lakh, I want to make 10 lakh as an additional income for this particular month, which means I need to do 10 trainings. So to go for 10 trainings, I need to at least contact 100 people and convert them. So if I am going to go with this large target, if at all, I will achieve only 50% of it. Then also it will be 5 lakh, which is better than the 90,000. The moment you are going out of your comfort zone and selecting some major goals or massive goals, that will bring success to you. And that is what startups are doing, the new startups. They are not limiting. They are not comparing themselves with others. They may not compare them with X company who is making 100 CR. Since last 25 years, they are into the market. What they are targeting is, within 2 years, we need to go for this 100 CR. So it is, if at all we think, it is not a smart goal. It is not at all attainable. So it is a massive goal. It is a big goal. Relevant. When we talk about the smart goal, the thing is coming is relevant. What is relevancy? See, relevancy doesn't have any sort of like meaning. It is just a perception. Now understand a basic concept of perception. We always learn things like ethical, unethical, honest, dishonest, blah, blah, blah. So many different terminologies has been put up in our mind from childhood. Now understand one thing. What is the definition of ethical and unethical? Something which is ethical according to you might be unethical for me. To take an example, killing someone is unethical. We learned this from childhood. But when army people are killing someone, it becomes ethical because they need to save the nation. When terrorists are killing someone, it again becomes ethical for them because they want to spread their particular portion or they want to achieve certain targets which they have kept. But according to us, it is unethical. So this is just about relevancy, ethical, unethical, honesty, dishonesty, product, success. Everything is just about the perception. Something which is right for you, something it may become wrong for someone else. So never go with that relevancy part. You just need to focus on only one thing, that you want to make your brand a large brand. Time is definite. From smart goal, only three things I agree. It should be, goal should be specific, measurable, and time-based. You need to have deadlines. The way Uma had explained that in next 5 years, what he wants to achieve within 5 years. Now for that goal also, Uma, you need to make sure that whenever you are doing hiring, you need to go with massive people who has the idea thinking pattern like you. You should not go with the normal people, average, retreat, or do nothing. Because do nothing and retreat will drop your company to below level. Normal level will just be there just to be in their comfort zone. But massive people will contribute towards your success. In terms of selecting your friends, in terms of selecting your mentors, you need to focus on massive level. How you can get benefited, how you can come out of your comfort zone. So according to us, goal should be always massive, which is simple. The definition of massive goal is it should be powerful. It should not let you sleep for 6 hours. It should be powerful. It should be related to personal life. Because understand one thing, from once you all are graduated, there will be one new concept which you will learn. There are two different life, personal and professional. We need to balance them. This is something, a concept which you will learn the moment you will be incorporated. But understand one thing. A person who is not good in professional life may not be able to good in personal life. Same, a person, if he is abusive in personal life, he will be abusive in professional life. And no one can balance personal and professional life. They go hand in hand. And that was the reason why in massive level slide, we have utilized few pictures where you are doing vacation, but at the same time, you need to work. If you want to start your own business, which is successful, you need to spend at least 18 hours in a day for your business. So definitely your family life and your personal life is going to be impacted a bit. So to manage everything, you need to consider it as a both are parallel. Whenever you are settling down any goals, it should be personal, where your own involvement is required. It should take you from one present level to next level. See, the simple definition of success is you need to achieve something which you have never been able to achieve in past. And the next is you need to go above that level. So each success will bring new goals for yourself. If you want to start up an organization and want to make it pan India, once you make it pan India, the next level is you need to make it pan world. So every time, whenever you are achieving any goal, it creates new opportunities and it creates more positive approach for next level. So whenever you are settling down your goals, it should have some massive impact. It should be powerful. The goal should be crazy, which is not letting you sleep for 8 to 9 hours. It should be huge goals. And to settle down that huge goal, one thing you need to understand, the difference between thinking and action. See, now understand one thing. Every one of us are good as a thinker. We Indians are base thinkers. But when it comes to execution, we are lacking over there. We have so many innovative ideas. Out of this 210 people, every person is having some unique ideas in their mind. But the main impact comes when they try to make it reality. The actions are not matching the reality. In first 5 years of my own career also, I was able to think good. But then I realized the thinking and actions are not matching. In terms of thinking, we may give advice to ask PM also that he should run the nation like this, but try to put it in action. How you are going to manage it? The biggest thing with us is we are not able to execute the things. We have good ideas of preparing business plans. We are having good ideas of preparing new things, innovative things. But when it comes to action, we need to spend our time on Netflix, Amazon Prime, Facebook, Instagram, Google, everywhere we want to spend some time, which is taking your goals away from you. So to become a successful, to achieve your massive goal, the first thing which you need to do is reason why you want to settle down this goal. See, do enough level of actions, because when you want to start your own business, the biggest thing is external parameters. See, your idea will be good, but if you are not able to consider the external parameters who are going to impact your entire business execution, you are going to fail miserably. So first thing, whenever you want to start your business or want to settle down certain goals, think about the reason why you want to do it. What should be the end result, which is a defined definition of the goal. If by doing this activity, what you want as a goal, then you need to find out the possibilities and priorities to achieve a goal. Today, if Mr. Uma or let's say Shravan wants to settle down his own company, which is into fertilizers. So first thing, what are the possibilities where he can sell this fertilizers to open that organization? What should be his priority? Find out the investors or prepare a company, find out land, what type of product quality he needs to produce. He needs to spend that time on that priorities which can contribute towards his goal. Not on meeting friends, not on chatting with or developing a network. First thing which is he needs to do is focusing on product. Facebook will not help you. If you are spending your time on non-productive things, it won't help you. See, the moment you define a goal, it should become your habit. Every day your focus should be there. Once you define the possibilities and priorities, involve others. Involve your professors who can guide you because they know everything about this industry. They are teaching you. So try to involve them and get guidance. See, to run a successful organization, definitely you need mentors. Who is guiding you? Today, if I am also running this business, I have someone who is mentoring me. Without a mentor, you won't be able to make a successful business, whether it should be your professor, whether your relatives, whether someone from industry, whether I, whether XYZ, who had really created the legacy. At the same time, you need a team of people. The way Uma have told, he failed to build the team because he was focusing towards a normal retreat at average people. The moment he will switch to massive people, see, talk to 100 people whom you want to involve in your team, then select the best one. Pay them high. Pay them higher cost than what market is paying them. The moment you will start paying high cost, the chances of their association with you will increase and they will put their more efforts, but hire the best one. The other mistake which startup does is they limited spending on the people. They spend less because of the budgeting part, blah, blah, blah. They always tell this. But according to us, you should spend maximum amount on your team. If I want to spend the first thing instead of marketing or anything, my first goal would be spending money on my team. Because the more I spend, the more dedicated they are going to work. And the second thing, when you are paying them high, they are going to take more responsibility. Then you need to understand your own personal responsibility and have a belief. Whomsoever wants to start their own business, they need to have one belief that they are going to make successful organization. Till the time you don't believe on your own product, people are not going to believe on you. If you don't have confidence on yourself, then why people should trust you? Why people should trust you? And then take the action. Also, whenever you are planning any business plan, any startup, you need to keep one thing in your mind. Whatever things you are thinking, you need to put 10 times higher efforts than that. If you think that within 6 months you are going to achieve the break even, take one thing in your mind, it will take 60 months, minimum 60 months. Because there are some other parameters also, like government, environment, so many parameters. So according to that particular point, you need to settle down your actions. Whether you need to work for 12 hours, 16 hours, 18 hours, if you need to make the biggest change, which I have seen between me and other people, why we are able to create this kind of organization, which is like in terms of when you search on Google, base sales trainer, real estate, base sales trainer, pharmaceutical company, base sales trainer, India, you will find us because of one reason. When others were making 10 calls, me and my team were making 100 calls. We have always taken 10 times higher action than what others are doing. What we have expected. If we thought that we need 100 clients, we always try to make it 1,000 clients. So according to that, we have taken the action. And to take that action, we have considered planning as a key part. See, how you plan your day is a critical thing. Whenever you have settled on some goals, you need to focus on that goals. And whatever activities which you are doing in a day, it should be aligned to that goals. And there should not be more than 5 priorities. See, every one of us are making to-do list. From childhood, the moment we start our academic year, we are trying to keep one schedule. That today I will woke up at 7 p.m., this, 7 a.m. I will wake up, then I will do prayer, then I will study this. But when we plan it, it is just going to be there for a month. Then after we forget it. In to-do list also, the same thing happens. We put so many activities in our to-do list, and then we are only able to do few activities. Why? Because we are not planning our day in a proper way. And to plan and execute your entire day, because that will define your success. And to do this, it's a simple exercise which you can do. And there are so many videos available on planning and everything on our YouTube channel, which you can check. There are some articles, blogs, everything is available. So you can visit our website also to know more. Whereas in the beginning, we were having some technical errors and there was some technical challenges. So I'm just taking these things a bit quickly because we have only 5 minutes left. So whenever you want to plan your day or plan your week, what we normally do as a business tycoon, we plan our week on weekends. We spend only 2 hours with ourselves where whatever things which are coming as an activity which you want to do on a particular day or week, we just list down all these activities. And then we find out this 4 level of differentiation. 1, your focus as an entrepreneur should be on doing only activities which are urgent and important. So you need to do it in that particular week. There will be certain activities when you list down. Those are important, but it is not urgent, like making some agreements, calling few people. You may be able to do it in the next week or next day. So you need to drop that activity from your to-do list for that particular week. And most of the activities, if you today, after this session, once you settle down and you see your last 2 months, what activities you have done, you will find that most of the activities, around 90% activities, which you have done, were not important or not urgent. And according to us, it should be dumb. You should not spend a single second for that particular activity. And the 4th level will be activities which are urgent, but someone else can do it. When we have a project, so there are few ideas which someone else can do. It is not just we can do the execution. And as an entrepreneur, you need to understand the moment you are reducing the number of things which are urgent and important, you are going to become successful. And most of your things should be done by someone else because effective delegation will make a company large. You need to involve other people also. Till the time you are not involving other people, they won't feel the ownership. And as a startup, you need more people who are contributing more towards the success of your business. You need to create a healthy team which can bring the results to you. Because understand one thing, no one is going to save you. You are the only person who are responsible for your success, your business success, your own startup success, everything. So you need to find out the ways. That's it from my side. Shravan, hand it over to you. Any questions, queries, do you utilize chat box.
Now I request the participants to post their questions in the chat box.
Anyone has any question, query?
Post the participants to post the questions in the chat box, please. In the chat box. So there's a question from
see, if you want to start your own company, which is totally focusing on the product, which are for the utilization of government. So first thing which you need to do is you need to focus on creating a network in government. See, when you want to do any type of business with government, you need to focus on networking part, because over there influence and networking will only help you to enter the premises. So first thing is you need to find out people who can give you influence. When you are putting your stuff in front of government, they need some references, good references, and at the same time price should be much more flexible and the product quality should be highest. See, to validate startup idea, first thing, understand one thing. There are so many products. Let's talk about SpaceX. Have we ever thought to go to space, live on moon? People are selling plots on moon. So according to me, to validate your idea of startup, it is yourself. If you think that the idea is going to work, you will make it work. See, if you talk about my own business, when we started in 2012, sales training was like, what is, when we go out to corporate and tell that you need to train your people, stay for, we have our management, we have leadership team who are training them. So they, no one was ready. But since that time frame, we have done so much aggressive marketing that today, you can see the difference. Everyone wants to become a trainer or consultant. So you yourself are going to validate your idea. If you think that the idea is going to work, you will make it work. Don't go with others' feedback, because as I told you, most of the people around us are in retreat. So they will tell you that your idea is not going to work. And the moment you get influenced by them, you will stop your innovative thinking. So validation of idea is just you. How do we look at people if they are not loyal to the organization? How do we judge it out? See, if someone is not loyal to your organization, immediately leave them. And for that, see, simple thing, whether person is loyal or unloyal. Two things you need to understand. If you are paying well, they are going to be loyal most of the time. Because a person is working for you to earn money. If you're not paying well, and if they are seeking for some other opportunities, you should blame your own self. The other thing which we need to understand, if you find some errors, give them chance, try to understand what they did and why they did. Because each time you should not just replace the people, try to find out some errors, improve it, and if it works, you go for it. And to keep watch on them, you should have targets for each and every person. The moment you will keep targets, if they are not able to achieve it, you will immediately find out the error, whether it is in your side or whether it is from someone else's side. Any other questions? Okay, so to make customer think your product is necessary, you need to first give them experience, create a success story, why, how this product is going to change their life and why it is mandatory. See, today, understand this, devices, smartphones. There was no requirement of this device, but today it is our requirement. Facebook. If we talk about Facebook, what we do? Liking pictures, posting things. But they had done the marketing in a way which had created a requirement. See, always understand one thing. You need to create the need. And to create that need, you need to go aggressively in the market. And you need to be present in front of multiple people who could become your buyers. And the moment they buy, you need to give them proper services that they are giving positive word of mouth of, about your product. And the more people are talking about your product, it will become a requirement, necessary.
How to overcome hidden haters work.
See, understand one thing, why we want to discuss about haters. See, everyone is having haters. See, today I am also having haters. Let's talk about this session only. For first 20 minutes, there was someone who were muting us again and again. He or she were taking our controls. So what we did? Have we stopped our execution? Me, Rajesh, sir, Shravan, have we stopped our executions? Let people do what they want to do. What we want to do, just focus on that. See, if you, as I told you again, this, when you hidden haters and when you think like this, you are just wasting your time and you are taking yourself away from success. Your core focus should be just yourself, your goal, go for it. If someone hates, it's good. See, let me give you an example. When I had written down one book, which is called 21 Simple Steps to Become Successful, the image which I have kept in each slide on the right section. So when I had written down this book, I got a call from, and published it, I got a call from someone. And he told me that, see, on page one, this is the error. On page two, this is the error. It is only 100 page book. On page 92, this is the grammatical error. On page 99, this is the grammatical error. He had told me all the errors. Like he had told me 16 errors. So you had not, and then told me that you are not focusing on proper content writing. Then I gave only one reply to him. That, sir, understand the beautifulness of my content. That within 3 hours of publication, you have bought up the book, you have read the entire book. That is the quality of content I have sold. Because you were able to read it. You are not likely to leave the book immediately. You liked it, so you have completed the book. See, there are haters. Let go with them. Whatever they want to do, they want to push you down. They will definitely try to make your life miserable, difficult. But your goal is just to overcome those activities. Just focus on your goal. Any other questions, queries from anyone? Okay, sir, Shravan. So thank you so much, entire team, for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for your wonderful presentation, sir.
Oh, thank you, sir. You are really grateful. Your delivery is excellent.
Thank you so much, sir. Hand it over to you, Shravan. Thank you so much, entire team. And thank you so much, students.
We are really proud of you. We appreciate your delivery.
Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. And participants, for the memory of the event purpose, please switch on the video for a few seconds. We will take a snapshot. I request all the participants to switch on the video. We can take a snapshot.
Yeah.